this award is quite an honor for me. It means a lot to have my research efforts, my leadership acknowledged, and to have the opportunity, you know, then to be able to talk about it and, you know, share what I've been doing and, you know, the importance of what I'm doing, you know, relative to NOAA, to NSSL, you know, as well as to, you know, the people who in the public, you know, that I think we also impact by what we do.
This award means a great deal to me. It's great to be recognized among outstanding scientists in the government from around the country, and especially because it's awarding something that I've worked so hard to achieve in a field that doesn't even feel like work to me. So it means a lot to me.
So Patrick, you're a recent grad student. What advice would you give to someone who's interested in the weather and getting a meteorology degree?
Well, I think, you know, probably first and foremost, the thing that's always mentioned is you need to have strong math skills, strong science skills. Any additional math that you can do in high school, if you can get into advanced classes, you'd certainly want to pursue that. But I think it's also important, some of the things that aren't mentioned quite as frequently are communication skills, good written and verbal skills in English, also computing skills.
The future of weather radar lies in phased array technology with its advanced multifunction capabilities and performance. Scanning the atmosphere more than 5 times faster than present radar, multifunction phased array radar holds significant promise for many radar users.
It's so fast, we believe that it can do weather in a superior fashion, and at the same time it can also track aircraft and even potentially non-cooperative aircraft for homeland security purposes.
Across the United States, various groups use Doppler radar to gather information vital to our everyday lives. From weather forecasting, to military operations, to emergency management, the Next Generation Weather Radar, or NEXRAD, ensures public safety and enhances commerce. NEXRAD, eye to the sky.
The Coastal and Inland Flooding Observation and Warning Project, known as CIFLOW, is a collaboration of multiple agencies and universities focused on one goal, a better forecast.
We have the whole entire continuum, from our rainfall researchers to social scientists to outreach extension experts with national sea grant programs. And what we're able to do with that then is we're able to actually track a raindrop from the sky to the summit to the sea.
All right, here we are at this white ambulance-looking mobile. Tell us more about this.
It actually was an ambulance at one point. It's modeled pretty much after the same thing, and we gutted it out, kind of replaced it with our own stuff. We took out all the, you know, bad benches that you associate with being hurt and put in some lazy boy recliners, make things nice and comfortable. The nice thing about it is it's got a lot of space. Put all kinds of computer equipment in there, communications equipment, that kind of stuff. So we can really jam a whole bunch of stuff in there. You can also carry around things like helium tanks in the oxygen storage places so that we can do a lot of mobile ballooning experiments and things like that using this vehicle. So it's a pretty versatile vehicle.
Hi everyone, I'm Kat Taylor, and welcome to our first video edition of That Weather Show. We're dedicating this episode to the brave scientist whose mission is to hunt tornadoes. That's right, we're talking about Vortex 2, the largest tornado field experiment ever.
We got to that area, we saw that there was a storm developing, it had a very good wall cloud on it, and we all kind of clicked into focus.
Everybody did their jobs, everybody executed correctly, we had all the instruments in the right place, everything was perfectly timed.
from a research standpoint, it was incredibly successful.
And we're into the details of that analysis now, and we're beginning to see a few things that might be new and exciting results to come from that data set.
It really was the most documented tornado in history.
NOAA and university researchers have the opportunity to change roles for a week and immerse themselves in the challenges of frontline forecasting. National Weather Service operational forecasters have a chance to examine emerging scientific and technological advances. Both walk away from the experience with increased knowledge of thunderstorm processes that will improve forecasts and vital forecasting tools.
Smart radars have been used recently for studying vast mountain areas in California. The devastation by wildfires leaves the area susceptible to debris flows, a direct result of heavy rainfall. Mobile ballooning research includes the recent TELEX project. This has led to increased understanding of the basic structure and evolution of electricity in thunderstorms.
This basic knowledge advancement is what it takes to then begin to move things into models and test them with theory as well.
Other areas which show similar positive results, if you will, in their ability to carry out the operational watch, you know, forecast and warning mission.
From the young students staring in awe at the surface of the sun to foreign students watching the weather in their home countries, our sphere has captivated all who see it. Our Science on a Sphere is not only educational, it has become an integral part of the National Weather Center.
Second floor, we have the development lab. This space is used by the NOAA National Severe Storms Lab for all types of research.
The Union City tornado in 1973 was a landmark event for weather research. Storm intercept teams observed and documented the entire life cycle of the storm. When combined with data from Doppler radar, scientists gained new understanding of storm formation and the early signs of a tornado.
May 3rd of 99 was a day that started off much like any severe weather day in Oklahoma. There's a risk of severe thunderstorms, a chance of tornadoes, going to be a likelihood of some hail and strong winds.
That was Dave Andra, the science operations officer for the Norman National Weather Service Forecast Office. As he recalls that historic day so vividly, it's amazing to think that 10 years have passed.
No matter where you are when a tornado approaches, the thing to remember is to take cover. You want to go to an interior room and put as many walls between you and the flying debris. It's the debris that kills and injures most people.